Hello my dear students, once again welcome to your online class. And in this today's video we'll be discussing about the 7th chapter of your chemistry textbook, that is the metallurgy. So what does this term metallurgy means? The metallurgy is the complete process of extraction of a metal from the mineral and to the finally pure form of the metal. Okay, so all the processes involved in the extraction of metal is termed as metallurgy. In your book, you'll find a vast description of all the processes and all the methods by which the metal is extracted from the minerals. But in this reduced syllabus, we have a very less few things to study, so which I have mentioned in the board also. So the first we'll be discussing on the occurrence of metal, where we'll learn about the minerals and the ore, and then we'll learn some of the common ores of aluminium. And secondly, we'll learn only the extraction of aluminium which involves the two processes, that is the Baer's process and the Hall-Hirols process. So now to begin with the first one, the occurrence of a metal. We know that metals are very important in our day-to-day life, but all the metals, they do not occur in a free state, because most of them, they are reactive. So usually the metals, they always occur in a combined state, except few like gold and platinum, which can be found in its native state. But for rest, all of them, they occur in a combined state, either with the sulfide or with the carbonates or with the oxides. Okay, so the metals, they usually occur in a combined state. Now, in order to obtain a metal from those compounds or a combined form of metal, the processes involved, they may be a grinding, okay, then we have a filtration, then we have a crushing, then we have a reduction, calcination, and much many more. But here we'll be discussing only about the two important topic, that is the minerals and the ores. So coming to the first one, what is mineral? The mineral is a naturally occurring substance which contains the ore along with other impurities like the sand, mud, silicas, and other form of impurities. So mineral, it's a naturally occurring substance from which the metals are extracted. Okay, but directly we do not obtain a metal from the minerals, because the minerals along with the metal, it contains a lot of impurities. Okay, so the naturally occurring substance which also contains the impurities are known as a minerals. But coming to the ore is also a mineral from where a metal is extracted industrially in a very cheap and convenient way. Okay, so therefore we can call that all the ores are minerals, but all the minerals cannot be an ore. So ore is only a part of a mineral from where the metals can be extracted. So many of the compounds or many of the metals, it occurs in the form of oxide, or some occurs in the form of carbonates, some occurs in the form of sulfides. But here we are interested to know only the common ores of the aluminium, because the aluminium is most widely used metal nowadays. Metal starting from a chocolate foil to making of an aeroplane, the aluminium is used. So therefore the extraction of aluminium is very, very important. Okay, so some of the common ores of aluminium are, so usually the aluminium has three ores, and they are, I have written the three important ores of aluminium. The first one being the bauxite, whose chemical formula is Al2O3.2H2O, and the second being a cryolite, which is Na3AlF6, and finally we have a corundum, whose formula is Al2O3. So these are the three common ores of aluminium found in the nature, and of this, during the extraction of aluminium, we use bauxite, because the bauxite, it contains 60% of aluminium oxide, that is Al2O3. So it contains 60% of aluminium oxide, and rest being the impurities like a sand, silica, and other particles. Okay, though cryolite and corundum, they also contains aluminium in it, but the percentage of aluminium that can be extracted from the cryolite and the corundum will be much more lesser than that can be obtained from the bauxite. So usually during the extraction of aluminium by the Baer's process, we use the bauxite as a main ingredient. So now let us try to understand the extraction of aluminium by the Baer's process followed by the Hall-Hirols process in details. So now, let us try to understand in details the process of extraction of aluminium. So during the extraction of aluminium, the bauxite is taken as the main ingredient, okay, because the bauxite contains more amount of aluminium oxide. So now to start with the first step involved in the extraction of aluminium, that is known as the Baer's process. So basically the Baer process here, it involves, or in the Baer's process what we get, it's utilized in getting the aluminium from the bauxite. So whatever is done in the Baer's process, it's just to obtain the aluminium. Okay, so the first thing that is involved is the ore, that is the bauxite, it is taken and then finely grinded. After it is finely grinded, it is mixed with the sodium hydroxide solution and then it is constantly heated for about 8 hours, okay, at a temperature of 150 degrees centigrade. So on doing that, what happens, the bauxite, it changes into the sodium meta-aluminate, that is NaAlO2. Okay, so once this is done, once the sodium meta-aluminate is obtained, the next step involved in the Baer's process is, it is diluted with water. Okay, that sodium meta-aluminate is diluted with water and then again heated at 50 degree centigrade to obtain the sodium hydroxide and aluminium hydroxide. So here what's happening, the sodium meta-aluminate is hydrolyzed. That means from the sodium meta-aluminate, now we are obtaining the aluminium hydroxide, which we obtain as a precipitate, okay, which we generally call PPT. Now this precipitate is finely washed. Okay, after washing this precipitate, what is done? It is further heated at 1000 degree centigrade. Okay, so once it is cleaned, okay, or washed with the water, and then it is dried. After drying, it is heated at a constant temperature of about 1000 degree centigrade, and finally we obtain aluminium. Okay, so this is what is involved in the Baer's process. It involves changing of a bauxite into the aluminium. Now this aluminium, which is also aluminium hydroxide, it has a great affinity for oxygen. That means using any suitable or a normal reducing agent, the oxygen cannot be removed from the aluminium because of the high affinity of oxygen for aluminium. So in order to obtain aluminium from aluminium, that is to carry out the process of reduction, here the electrolytic reduction is preferred, okay, which is known as the Hall-Herold process. So the Hall-Herold process is basically the electrolytic reduction of aluminium to aluminium oxide. So this is done in a special case of electrolytic cell, okay, which is made out of iron. Okay, so here in this figure you can see the outer case is made out of iron and then the inner one, okay, it is made out of carbon layering, which itself acts as a cathode, and then we have a graphite electrode or an anode. Okay, so and then the bottom of this tank is made inclined, okay, so that the molten aluminium can pass and easily can be collected. Now as an electrolyte, the three important things are taken, okay, the first one being the aluminium itself, the aluminium hydroxide. Apart from that, aluminium, the cryolite and the fluorosphere is also taken. In what ratio? It is 6:2:2. That means the 60% cryolite, 20% fluorosphere and the 20% aluminium. So once this mixture is taken, so it is heated, this whole electrolytic vessel is heated about 950 degree centigrade, okay, with the help of the electric heater. So it is constantly heated so that all the electrolytes here, it remains in a molten state. So there is a reason why we use a mixture of cryolite and a fluorosphere. So what does the cryolite do? Usually the melting point of the aluminium is around 2050 degree centigrade. So addition of cryolite, it reduces the melting point, it reduces to 950 degree centigrade. And the fluorosphere, what does it do? It increases the conductivity of that solution or the electrolyte or the mixture. So that's why the cryolite and fluorosphere is added, in order to increase the conductivity and in order to lower the molten temperature or the melting temperature. Okay, and on top of that, carbon is sprinkled, okay, here. So this carbon, or not carbon, it's a coke. Okay, coke is put on the surface of the electrolyte, in which acts as an insulator. Okay, it does not allow the heat to escape out. So now when all of these compounds, it melts, it it is in a molten state, what happens? It breaks into its constituent ion, like the cryolite, it gives a sodium, aluminium and a fluorine. The fluorosphere, it gives a calcium and a fluorine. And ammonia also, it breaks into the aluminium and oxygen. Now when we go into the metal activity series, we see that the aluminium is at the bottom of the series. Okay, so that's why, because of the preferential discharge of the anion and the cation, the aluminium, it will migrate towards the cathode, that means to the bottom or to the whole cage of this vessel. Okay, and then in the cathode, what reaction occur? The aluminium, it gains 3 electron and becomes a aluminium atom. And then this aluminium atom, all it mixes together and form a molten solution. And then finally the aluminium, because of this inclined plane, it flows down and it can be collected. Now coming to the anode, the oxygen, it migrates towards the anode, okay, the oxygen ion, and then it loses 2 ion and produces a nascent oxygen. And this nascent oxygen, it combines with another oxygen to form an oxygen molecule, which is liberated as a gas. And due to which the anode, it gets oxidized. Okay, so therefore there is a necessity of replacing an anode again and again. So this is all involved in the extraction of aluminium. So the first one is the Bayer's process, that involves of extraction of aluminium from the bauxite, and then the second, the electrolytic reduction of ammonia to obtain aluminium. Okay, so these you learn in details, okay, especially this diagram and the reason for each of it. Why is cryolite used? Why is the fluorosphere used? Why is the bottom inclined and all? Okay, so this all is included in your chapter extraction of metal. So only go through these two parts in your chapter. And if you have any queries, you are always free to ask me in my WhatsApp number. Thank you.